And then she stepped onto the ball.
No way. That's hilarious. Yeah. Hi there, welcome to Best of Friends. I'm Abs.
And I'm Rani, and this is a show that really puts your friendship to the test.
Three tasks.
Three treats.
One's down to luck.
The rest is their choice.
Will they play fair?
Will they play dirty?
Will they still be the best of friends?
We are the guys from Bristol. And we are the best of friends. We are the best of friends. We are the best of friends.
Gareth is the most mature one in the group, but he's very supportive when it comes to times when people are upset.
Matt has got really good imagination, so when we're like in a situation, he can think up of a plan very quickly.
Louis, well, he's intelligent and mischievous.
Oscar is quite annoying, but he's very funny. He likes fighting, and he really tries to be like Pingu.
Ben is just the tiniest bit annoying, but he's a very, very talented artist, and he's a very good friend. If I lost him, I'd go crackers.
Hi, Rami!
Morning, lads!
They're a lively bunch, aren't they?
They're going to take over the show.
Yeah, too right.
Let's hope so. OK, five best mates. We've got some news on you. Now, Gareth, I've heard there's something you would really hate to do. What is it?
Operations.
Operations! So, are you a qualified surgeon?
No.
Now, next, we've got Oscar. I've heard that you hate pop stars. Tell me a bit more about that.
Well, it just, these modern pop stars, not northern, modern, they're just, they're not exactly my cup of tea. Busted. Their hairstyles, they're just real young show-offs. I mean, couldn't they get someone like Shirley Bassey or Beethoven instead? Mm. Goldfinger!
You just spat a little bit down your lip when you did that. But that's okay. Nice to meet you, Ozzy.
Nice to meet you, Ozzy.
All right then, Matt, moving on to you. Now, you're a footballer, aren't you?
Yep.
And you once lost the game 21 goals to one.
Well, we did, but first I've got to say it was a friendly.
Right. And that makes a difference?
No, but because we still lost, but it didn't go down in the league, which was good.
And Louis? What was your biggest adventure to date?
My biggest adventure was climbing up Mount Vesuvius in Italy.
OK, it's time to form your first circle of friendship, guys.
All right, let's
get it. We are the best of friends! We are the best of friends!
And cut! Because it's time for your first unlucky dip. Bring on the sweets. This bag contains five sweets.
Now, of those five sweets, three of them will turn your tongues blue and you'll be doing the first task of the day. If you end up with a clear tongue, then that's great news. You're going to be doing the first treat. OK, so shut your eyes. I'm going to pass these along now. No peeking. Let's find out who's doing what.
So, who'll get the first of our three tasks?
You suck!
Will it be Gareth, Oscar, Matt, Ben or Louis?
Pop your tongues out! It's Gareth, Oscar and Ben who get the first of our tasks. Have a look at yourselves. Well, enough celebration for you guys, because Abs, our turn.
Bring on the presenters, unlucky dip. What do we do now?
You suck!
Bad luck, old bean.
I hate one of the sounds of that. I've got a blue top.
Let me see. You got a blue one! Boys, are you ready for your first treat?
Yeah.
Good, because this one's going to have you climbing the walls.
Now, right there is a slippery, slimy squid, because our first task is all about sushi. Our three taskers really have to pass this task, so that only two of them have to go on and do the next task. Now, it is going to involve eating it eventually, and I absolutely hate fish, so fingers crossed. Let's go meet Theo.
Welcome, Paul, who's our instructor for the day.
Hey, guys.
And he's going to be showing us the ropes. Oh! Just stop hanging around, let's go.
Hey guys, this morning we're going to be making sushi. And we start pressing them out. One cucumber and one piece of fish. Let's keep rolling the mat, pull it forward, do it with a little bit of water. We do the rolls first, and then we slice them later, and then we can eat them.
All right, guys, fancy having a go?
Yeah.
Well, when I found out what the task was, because I don't like fish, and whenever I have it, it makes me puke a lot. I was just like really upset, like, oh no, how am I going to do this?
I'm finished, I've done mine.
Doesn't exactly seem like a task, does it?
No. Pretty high, isn't it?
Yes.
But we can take it on, can't we?
Yep.
Have you climbed before, Louis?
Yeah, I've climbed a volcano. And I've climbed a ladder and a small wall.
A small wall. What about you, Matt?
I've climbed a much smaller version of this in a park and a ladder.
All right then, well, I haven't climbed anything at all, and I'm maybe a little bit scared of height, but we're not going to tell anyone that. So, Paul, it's up to you now.
Okay, guys, are we all keen?
Yeah.
And then we're doing the gate up, so it's nice and safe. And you're going to pull the rope down. Yeah. Any time it comes down, you pull it up.
Right, okay.
Okay, we ready, Lou? Brilliant. Just keep pushing with your feet. And now you need to push with your right foot. Get your left foot up. Excellent.
I'll come down now.
Lean back, Louis.
Cool.
Whoa. Next time to the top.
You're just pulling down gently. Louis pulling up. So you're going to the top?
I've got a tiny feeling that I won't be this time.
Any tips?
I know.
Climb.
What happens if I fall?
And then you can put the left foot beside it.
I'm scared of
heights.
Guys.
That's it.
So we've sliced and diced our sushi rolls. Tio, what's next?
I got a surprise for you, Ed.
Go on then.
Look. Ooh, it's a big squid though.
Okay. You're a qualified squid surgeon.
Just gross bits of slime, nothing to worry about.
This should be rated 18 since it's so scary. Thank you.
We've got some scallops here. It's very, very fresh.
So you're going to have to take a bite out of all the sushi that we've prepared. The sushi rolls, the squid you want there, and also the scallop there. So then, who wants to go first?
I accept the challenge, Sir Abs.
Did your mum teach you any table manners? Have you had some?
Get on.
Well done.
Go, Gareth.
It didn't really taste nice and it was very hard to chew.
Is he going to swallow the lot?
Is he not?
Then just take a big bite out of it.
Why I don't want to taste it again is because it's so horrible. It's just not my cup of tea.
Well done. Very good. And thirdly and finally, Ben, it's your turn.
I'm going to start off with the sushi.
Go, Ben!
Action, hang on, continue, okay?
You don't want to continue?
No.
Come on, Ben! You can do it!
The others were like, come on, Benny, you can do it! And the crew were like, go on, Benny boy, you can do it!
Come on, you can do it! Just try it, okay? You can do it! Yes, that's it, come on!
Thanks for the encouragement of all of us. Ben has finally done it, but I don't think he's going to try sushi in a hurry.
Ah, boys, the bouldering wall. We don't need ropes, just need hands and feet to follow me.
Squid or scallop?
Squid.
3, 2, 1, scallop!
Thank you. High five. Thank you. Good job. Good job.
Good man.
Thank you.
But I'm going to let the guys tell you about the treat.
Go
guys,
on then.
Tell us.
We went to a climbing centre in Bristol. We had to wear things around our waist.
Put it this way, you get a major wedgie.
Oh, right. Okay.
But we weren't expecting it.
Well, it sounds more like a task than a treat, getting wedgied. So it sounds like you guys had a really good treat. I'm very jealous. Taskers, why don't you tell these guys what we got?
We were taught by the top chef there how to make sushi, and after that, once we made it, we had to eat it.
So did you like it?
No, I especially didn't like the chopped up squid.
And I got a problem because I don't really like fish, and so I had to eat it, otherwise I would have let my friends down.
What these two really need to know is if we passed or failed the task, so if you'd like to tell them.
We passed it.
We passed.
Yeah! Yeah, wedgie! I like that. All right, well, that's really good news because that means on the next task, only two people have to do it.
OK, your first option is that the two that we require can volunteer right here now amongst yourselves. You can say, yeah, OK, all right, yeah. I've done a treat, so maybe I'll go on and do a task. That's one of your options. Or you can rely on the unlucky dip, you know, like we did a bit earlier on, and that'll select two of you to go on and do the second task. You've got plenty to chat about, so we'll let you get on with it. We'll just be over here.
Shall we? Only for the lucky dip.
Just a second.
But that's not fair.
No, it's not really fair.
You do a treat and...
You wait.
We could do a task tomorrow. We might do the lucky dip if we complete the task.
All five of us. Yeah. Then we can do the big treat. Okay.
All right, guys. You've made your decision, I guess. Yeah. All right. Well, don't tell us just yet, because it's time to form your second circle of friendship.
We are the best of friends.
Tell us what we're up to, Louie.
We are volunteering, and they are going through to the treat.
Oh,
now, was that a tough decision to make?
Yes, because I really wanted to do another treat, but then they wouldn't let me.
Quite tough.
So why didn't you just go for the unlucky dip and leave it to chance?
I know, that's what I was thinking, but they didn't let me because I thought it was...
But Matthew here is very generous.
Are you saying we're forcing you?
Yes!
Ooh.
We have a very selfish friendship.
Tomorrow we're leaving it to the lucky dip, hopefully.
Yes.
Well, we'll see what happens.
Only fate will decide.
Very philosophical, Oscar. So you three are doing the treat and you two, unfortunately, doing the next task. What we've got to find out is who's coming along with you. Good luck, you go first. It's there. Stop trying to touch my hand. We've got our sweets. What do we do now, boys?
You suck!
Thank you, you've made your point.
We got it!
Ah, oh, poor Arnie.
You're it!
Okay, Musketeers, one for all.
Best of friends!
On guard! Come on then, I've got you.
Guys, hold it. Even D'Artagnan needs some basic training.
Okay, sorry about that. Guys, this is Jonathan. Jonathan is a fight coordinator and he's going to be telling us a little bit about fencing today. So line up.
Right, okay, first thing we're going to do is learn how to salute because this is a weapon of honour. Lifting the sword up to the heavens, into the mouth as if to kiss it. Forward to your opponent, in and away. Standing tall, proud, looking good, with a twinkle in the eye. And a song in the heart.
All right, lads, welcome to Woodchester Mansions. This is the venue for your second task. The man to tell us all is Andy. How are you, Andy?
Not too bad.
Good stuff. Now, Andy, please tell these boys why we are here.
Right, as Rani said, this is Woodchester Mansion, but it is one of the most haunted places in Britain. Right. And we have one corridor upstairs, which is particularly haunted by an old stonemason. So for your task today, you have to go up on that top corridor, walk from one end to the other on your own, stay at one end for 30 seconds, and then walk back to the other end.
How long is the corridor?
It's probably 50 metres long.
50?
If at any time you freak out, or something goes wrong, you'll fail your task. Okay?
You only get one chance.
One chance.
Okay, this is your basic on guard position. Advance. Retire, retire. Advance, advance. One big retire. One jump forward, big advance. Now the backhand, the left hand, or your right hand goes up into a slight curve like this. You can actually comb your hair there or tickle the feathers on your hat if you've got one. Extend the arm. Lunge, lunge, lunge. Hey.
Hey.
Good. Good, and then as we lunge, la. Hey, la.
You broke your sword.
Hey, la. You having fun?
Yeah.
Good.
Oh, abs.
Yeah.
When can we start hitting each other?
Good question. Jonathan, when can we start smacking each other?
As soon as you like. But first, we must put masks on. Now that we've got all our safety kit on, Musketeers, all for one!
Now all for you! Come on, you're gonna
fight! I surrender.
Now, Louis, here we are on the second corridor. Are you ready to take on this task? Okay, what I'm going to give you to help you along your journey, a video camera so you can tell us how you're feeling on the way down, and also a torch.
Thank you.
Good luck, and get yourself into position. Off you go. There we go. Good luck.
I'm on my way now. Feeling weird.
Doing really well, Louis.
It's feeling scary.
I heard the owls outside and the, we thought it was him sleeping, but it was actually the wind and it was really scary. We even saw a few bats.
I'm ready.
Coming back now.
Yeah, make your way back.
Ooh, I heard some noises then. I can still hear the noises. And I'm back.
Yay! Well done! Well done!
We started off with a sponge sword, but then we got onto real swords, which was my favourite bit. Actually, a part of the sword really hurt my little fingers just here. It's like I cracked a bone or something. The boys' moves were very good. It was a fair play with Benedict and Gareth. Good lunges. Abs was pathetic. Don't tell him that, right? But he's a very kind man, even if he is pathetic at fencing. Anyway, I've got to go now. Goodbye.
I need to give up with you. You're
Are you ready, gentlemen? On guard. Oh, and hold there. Very good indeed, gentlemen.
Oh, come on, you're going down, Abs.
In your dreams, little man. Bring it on.
Come on, bring it on.
Yeah, come on, man.
Point four. Good. Into that chest. Good. Hold there.
And that is the victor. Yeah.
You cheat.
Excellent.
Yeah,
lose it. Rematch. Back right here next week. One of the most important things about fencing, gentlemen, is that it is an honourable sport. Hey!
Take hold of the torch. Get yourself into position, and good luck. And remember, we're right here. Okay? Off you go. Just tell us how you're feeling.
Feeling a bit scared now.
You're at the halfway mark, mate. You're doing great. You still with us?
Quite scared.
One, two, three, four, five, six, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Yeah, hey, come on back to us.
Counted up to 30.
I can hear the wind, which is making it a bit more spookier.
I'm getting closer and closer.
Feeling really good.
And I've done it.
Well done. You feeling good?
Yep.
And now it's my turn. I've got my torch, I've got my camera. It's quite funny. You can hear so much more when you're on your own. At the end. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 30. And I'm on my way back again. Get back. Yay! I'm glad to
be back.
Very impressed. You passed your task, boys.
Yes! That's it. We passed the task. That's excellent news. Thank you very much for that, Andy.
It's not haunted, really. Not as far as I'm concerned.
Hang on a minute. Ooh, what a trickster. Man, my day started off great.
Do you know what? You can talk. I had to have a really fishy task to start with, all that sushi. Had to make it and then eat it. It was disgusting.
I was great, though. I was climbing the walls and I got right to the top, hit the red button. You should have seen me.
High tens.
Top of the world, mate. Top of the world.
You were great. I was very proud of you, in fact. Mm. Wonder what we're going to be doing tomorrow.
And a clue.
They haven't given us any clues. They usually do, you see.
Go away. I'm sick.
You all right?
Abs, don't touch me. It's contagious. Back away.
Oh, it's disgusting. Is it chicken pox?
It's some animal pox. I don't know what it is. Just leave me alone. Tell everyone I'll see them tomorrow, if I'm OK.
Hang on a second. What's that?
Is don't touch it.
That's not chicken pox or animal pox. That's lip gloss. Nice try. See you in 5 minutes.
You've cured me. Morning.
Morning.
How are we feeling today?
Great.
Now we're all back together. First of all, Taskers, how did it go yesterday? We know it was quite a spooky experience. Tell us a bit more.
Well, we went to a haunted house.
Oh no.
Extremely scary to go through that corridor. You heard ghosts.
You heard them.
It was very, very creepy. You wouldn't have liked it. But you guys, you were building a fence, weren't you?
No.
What were you doing?
We were doing fencing like...
Waha!
How about you, son?
Hiya!
Great style there.
And Abs lost to everybody. Abs demanded a rematch.
I wanted a rematch and they wouldn't give me one.
Tough.
You probably lost anyway.
I would.
I'll get you next time, Squirt.
I'd like to see you try bigger.
Ooh! Bring it up. Okay. Stop this fight and talk. So what we need to know is, did we pass or did we fail the task?
Well, unfortunately,
we passed.
No!
Yeah.
No!
That's good news, Elsie.
So you've got a few options now. Let me tell them to you. The first one is that one of you can just volunteer to do the last task by themselves, or you can rely on the unlucky dip to select that one person.
Now, as it's the hardest task, we will give you the option that all five of you can volunteer and do it together as mates. The choice is yours.
OK, have a nice loud chat amongst yourselves. See what you want to do.
Yeah, we'd be in for each other. If one person fails, we'd all fail together. Yeah. But then if we all do it, and one person goes through, we all go through without one person being left on his own, so it's fair.
If one person does it, we've got better odds of winning, because we don't have to rely on three other people.
All right then, fellas, you've had plenty of time to chat about it. We're going to form the final circle of friendship.
Will someone volunteer?
Will it be the unlucky dip?
Or will they do the last task together?
We are the best of friends.
We are the best of friends. Guys, we need to know your final decision. You had a good chat about it. Are you decided?
We're all going to volunteer to do it.
Are you happy to do that?
Yeah, we're happy.
Well, good luck in your final task. What we need to find out now is who's coming along with you, so bring on the presenter's unlucky dip.
Thank you.
What do we do?
You suck!
Thank you.
Stick your tongue out.
How are you feeling?
Nervous.
I want to get this up and done with.
Good idea. Okay, so should we just venture off? Remember that if one of you fails, you all fail.
Since our maestro passed away in 1963, I'll provide the music. Dun dun dun!
It really is that scary. Take a little walk in there and look at your task. Now your task is going to be to pull out 20 worms in 1 minute. I'm afraid to say it's an individual task. This isn't a team game. All right then, Louis, you've got 20 worms in there. You've got a minute and it starts now. Come on, mate.
Oh, no.
That's one. Yeah. Come on, won't bite you. It's a worm. Come on.
I like it felt like last night's a peas, but smaller in a bowl. And the worms were all slippery and it smelt like raw fish.
Stop there, please, mate. Your time is up. All right, Matt, your time starts now.
You're absolutely sick, really. It looked okay from the start, but when we found out what we had to do, I thought, no way am I going to be able to do this.
Right, Benny boy, 20 stinky worms in 1 minute and your time starts now.
My heart was because I wasn't sure if I was going to get them or not, and if I didn't, then I'd know I'd let my friends down, so it's very tough.
20 worms in that pot. Well done, mate. Yes. Are you feeling confident, Oscar? Okay, then. Your time starts now. Couple there, that's two.
I think Oscar won't do it, but he's quite good with maggots, but this is different to fishing.
Lots of maggots in there. 18, 19, and that's it. So you're one short, okay? You all right? Well done, mate. It was a good effort. Good luck, Gareth. 3, 2, 1, time starts now. There's one. Great.
I'm quite worried about Gareth and Oscar because they're not that quick and they're not very confident in doing things like that. So they're normally like, oh no, what am I doing? What am I doing? Like, how do I do it? How do I do it? They panic a lot. So that's the trouble.
Let's see. Now, well done, guys. You took on the task as a team of five. Do you want to find out how you've done? Mm-hmm. Okay, then, let me tell you. Ben, you completed the task. Well done. Gareth, 20 out of 20. Oscar, unfortunately, mate, you only got 19 out of 20. You failed the task. And you two?
16.
You know what you got. Yep, 16 each. So I'm really, really sad to say that you haven't passed today's final task and we're not going to be going on to do the treat, okay? What are you thinking, Oscar?
He's just sad that he let us down and so, but he didn't.
But do you feel like they've let you down?
No matter whatever happens, we'll still be best of friends.
I hope so, because you are a nice bunch of lads. And we've had fun filming with you, okay?
The Best of Friends final treat. We're here to make a spy movie. Guy? Hello?
Ronnie, hi. Did you not get our text?
No, where's your outfit? We're making a spy movie.
Well, that's the thing. See, we failed the final task, so no spy movie for us today. Come on, I'll tell you all about it on the way home. I'm sorry too, you look great. Come on, I'll walk you home. Yeah, we had this final task today.
With the maggots and the worm, I thought it was quite horrible, a bit disappointed that I failed my test.
When I found out we were doing maggots, even though I'm good at handling maggots, I was so shocked. I mean, 20 worms in a big tin of little bazookas which are trying to shoot you. But they cheered me on, and even though I didn't get 20, at least I felt more relaxed.
The worst moment, apart from the maggots and worms, was probably the haunted house, when we just realised how long the haunted house actually was, how dark it was and drafty.
I've had so much fun during the 2 days, even though we've not completed the last task.
And after being on the show, I am really glad to come here with my friends, and I've made some new friends with the crew. Yeah.